Happy Easter, everybody! Do you also struggle with painting your Easter eggs and find it stupid and boring? Then stay tuned, I'll show you how Easter eggs are painted the engineer's way. Guten Tag, everybody, and welcome to CNC Kitchen! So my manual painting skills are really awful. I rather do a proper design in CAD or any other drawing software and then use a machine to perform the manual but very accurate labor. So I'll show you today how I painted my Easter eggs with a simple 2.5-axis CNC. This machine is known under the name SphereBot or EggBot, which can be used to paint many kinds of round objects and actually dates back to the 90s. It consists out of one rotary axis which turns the egg and one axis which turns the pen. Both are directly powered by standard NEMA 17 stepper motors. The third binary axis is a small RC servo which lifts and lowers the pen on the object you're painting. There are plenty of different designs to this machine which you can find online. I have chosen a 3D printable design which you can download on Thingiverse. The design is pretty simple. There are just some brackets which are then connected via threaded rods. The only thing which I had to change were the suction cups to firmly hold the egg. Since I did not have any Nerf darts, I printed the cups in Ninja Flex filament, which worked pretty well. The electronics were a different story. There's quite a simple version online which uses the Adafruit stepper shield. This one uses I2C to communicate with the Arduino and the firmware is also trimmed to that. I did not have any of these, so I set up the electronics on a breadboard with an Arduino Nano and two Pululu 4988 stepper motor drivers. There's a very old firmware and schematics online which also work with this configuration. Adding all the jumper cables makes it look a little bit messed up, but hey, it works and that's what counts. This is nothing permanent, so there is no need to put everything on a neat PCB. After making some small changes with the electronics and fiddling around with the firmware, it was finally working. So the designs are now created as a vector drawing in Inkscape and saved with a special plugin SG code. Unfortunately, since the EggBot does not run global as my CNC, I could not use the universal G-code sender to get the G-code on my egg painting machine. But I found a Chrome extension which lets me do exactly that, so I used this in the end. Let's paint some pretty Easter eggs. Please remember that it's very important to set up the egg properly in the rig. Of course, since it's Easter you wanna watch your calories and you anyway eat too much, we gonna draw the nutritional facts on the egg. And if you're also fed up as I am over screwing up the drawing 3 times in a row, you can at least satisfyingly watch the ink being washed away underwater. It's also nice to draw some pretty patterns on the eggs, since it makes them kind of unique. Happy Easter, everybody! I hope you liked this video. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. And as always, auf Wiedersehen and until next time.